He stayed with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for less than 2 years. Okay, for less than 2 years. And he was what, 12 years old when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died? Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, the one that once we see, read the Quran, read the tafsir and say, Ibn Abbas said, that's it. He was very young with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also Anas radiallahu anhu in the household, or he was in the household of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning his servant. And we tend not to go there and much, but through the youth and through the those who were very close to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, most of them are youth, we get very huge advice and way of life that is detailed of how the personality of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. So we get Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu describes how he used to sleep in the same bed with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Maymuna radiallahu anhu. Maymuna, who is the aunt of Ibn Abbas. So he was allowed to enter that house and come out because the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his aunt. Okay? So he would say, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and my aunt would sleep this way on the pillow and sleep that way. So his head would be the other way. And what does he do? When he hears Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam moves, he would look and open up his eyes and look how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam moves in his sleep. And as soon as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wake up, what does he do? We find a beautiful hadith when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was praying and at night, and Ibn Abbas comes and tried to get close to behind Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rasulullah tried to get him next to him, and he resisted, kept resisting. And finally Rasulullah ﷺ grabbed him next to him. Okay. Now, afterwards Rasulullah ﷺ asked him, why did you resist? He said, you are Rasulullah and I'm a little boy. How can I be praying next to you? Okay? Yes. So Rasulullah ﷺ puts his hand on the heart and the chest of Ibn Abbas. Allah give him the interpretation of the Quran. Okay? Give him radiallahu anhu when he says, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I lived with him for 10 years. He never told me, why did you do this or why didn't you do this? Show us the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The leadership that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to give to those young ones. Okay? Usama ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu, as he was a Rasulullah sallam appointed him a leader of an army, as we all know, before he died. And when Rasulullah sallam died, when he was 18 years old, and some said that, what do we need to do? We need to change this? And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, this is the whole army would go the same way that Rasulullah sallam organized it, with the head. And with the head meaning Usama ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu. And he would go behind him. And he wanted to get off the horses. No, you stay on it and I will stay behind you. But Usama ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu did not get that leadership because he is Usama ibn Zayd. No, it is because he was qualified by the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to have that responsibility. He was very mature in a very young age. Very mature in a very young age. And to give you an example of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how he dealt with the young ones, Ali radiallahu anhu, and he used to say, of course he was raised in the household of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to say, I would come home and talk to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Rasulullah would not interrupt me. I would sit there, say whatever it is that I want to say, keep talking, and Rasulullah would listen and sit and listen to me. And then the time when I do not talk, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would start me so I can speak. So he would talk, open subject, so he would talk. Okay? We get from that how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would even takes the opinion, Ali radiallahu anhu. Many times Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would go to him and ask him his opinion. And even though Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam raised him, but he would ask him an opinion. One matter, the matter of Aisha radiallahu anha, the matter of ifk, the hadith of ifk. She was accused radiallahu anha with what she was accused with. One of the people that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went and asked about his opinion in this matter was Ali radiallahu anha. Okay. In this huge matter, in this matter that is so sensitive and so delicate and has to do with the honor, he would talk to Ali radiallahu anhu about it. I'm going to end up with this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us Ibrahim alayhi salam, okay, as he alayhi salam advised his children, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ بِهَا بِوَتْ with لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Okay? Being a Muslim and surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. When Allah told him to surrender, to become a Muslim, and he said, أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ. Meaning Ibrahim alayhi salam gave it to his son. Now Ya'qub alayhi salam is giving it to his son. What is that? إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي. Have you ever thought about that? That you talk to their children and whom do you worship after me? When I die, whom do you worship? You would think that he was a prophet of Allah. He was a messenger of Allah. And that is goes without saying. And his practice is always tawheed. So it's not a subject to talk about with his children. It's come with the category, with the package, if you will. No. Inna Allah astafa lakum al-deen. The message is given to them first. Okay, فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. That is the message he's telling them. Before he dies, the ayah after that is أَنْ كُنْتُمْ شَهَدَاء إِنْ حَضَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتُ إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي. Another word, now he's asking them the result of that. He's giving them the test at the end. Okay, before he died, whom you gonna worship after me? نعبد إلهك وإله أباك إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق إله واحدا ونحن له مسلمون. تلك أمة قد خلت لها ما كسبت ولكم ما كسبتم. It is a nation came and gone. Our nation is here and will never be gone. Okay, our nation is here and will never be gone until the day of judgment, because we still be a group who hold into La ilaha illallah from those who follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam until the day of judgment. But our job is to be from this group, to be in that purity of La ilaha illallah in Muhammad Rasulullah.